Hi everyone, my name is Mama Tamago, and I have something super duper exciting to share with you all. As you all know, I already love Mix It Up, and when I saw that Atom put out a free OBS plugin for a vertical canvas, my immediate thought was, how do I connect this with Mix It Up? And you know what? I got you covered. We are going to go over a little bit about what this Atom plugin does, and then how you can use the functionalities of Mix It Up with the Atom plugin so that you can make short form video content a lot easier. With Mix It Up, you can already do exclamation point clip in chat, have it automatically take a Twitch clip, take that Twitch clip and post it in your Discord, all with a chat message, all with a channel point redemption. If you don't know what I'm talking about or you don't know how to set that up, I do have a YouTube tutorial that will pop up, teach you how to do that. Now in the vertical format, so you don't have to go back, reformat it in whatever editing software that you use and then also post it. You're essentially saving the middle step of formatting all of your sources for vertical. Let's look at what Atom is, what the OBS plugin does specifically, and how you can connect that with Mix It Up. It says Atom.tv. Actually, I don't think it's called Atom.tv. I think it's just called Atom. I also hope I'm pronouncing it right. Basically, it is also another bot solution. There is a monthly fee. It is $4.99 a month or $50 a month where you can get all of the features that Atom has. What I am interested in exploring in this video is actually the free Atom vertical plugin. All you have to do is download OBS 29 or above. To download, just click on this download button. What's really cool about this plugin is that if you have a TikTok stream key, you can actually stream in the same instance of OBS in your horizontal format to Twitch, which is what you're used to. And it also adds another canvas so that you can stream in the vertical format at the same time. Before this plugin, in order for you to stream from your computer to TikTok, you would need to open another instance of a streaming software. So whether that be Streamlabs OBS, OBS, or the TikTok Live Studio, this will actually just mesh everything together into one OBS program instance. It's actually really freaking cool. If you don't have a TikTok stream key, you can still use this in terms of recording your content and also clipping your content so that you don't have to reformat it again. It is a completely new canvas that once you download it, it is a completely new canvas that shows up in your OBS. So this is what my OBS looks like after having downloaded the vertical plugin. Over here on the right hand side, you can see it is a completely new canvas for you to basically put anything you want on there as if it was regular OBS. You have your vertical sources, very similar to just your regular sources here, but it is vertical. I basically just added all of the sources that I would want in here. It takes all of the sources that you already have in OBS so you don't have to input it again, and then just put it in the order that I want. So this is what it can potentially look like. Down here you can have your tutorial, your gameplay. Up here is the webcam. It's a very familiar format that we see on TikTok all the time. You don't need to edit this outside. This will just be recorded like this. Let me walk through all of the different settings on here. For this tutorial, all you got to do is to just make sure that your sources are in whatever order you want, very similar to how you would set up with OBS. And then when you go to vertical, you can see what it actually looks like if you were to record it. Down here on the left hand side, we have streaming if you have a TikTok stream key. Over here, we have the record button. And then over here, they have something called backtrack clip vertical. This is basically taking a clip of the last 1 minute, or actually of the last however many seconds that you want. To change that setting, you would click on the gear on the right hand side, and this is your vertical settings. If you see that it's just a regular settings, that's not where it is. In the general, you have your resolution here. You can set your bit rate and then the audio rate. I don't actually know what the audio should be. That's probably fine. And then this is where you can set the length of whatever you want your backtrack to be. I set it for a minute, you set it for whatever. You can choose the file path of where the recording goes to. And over here, you can set the hotkey of whatever you want to record for the vertical format. I have it set as Control-Alt-8. You can do whatever you want, but if you want to follow along, this is what I have it set as. And to test this, you will probably want to have backtrack always on. If you don't have this on and you're testing it and the backtrack doesn't turn on, it's because you're either not recording or not streaming. So if you have this on, you can do your testing. Streaming settings, this is where you would put your keys. And then recording settings, you can also choose where this goes. And then we just press OK. So after all of this is set, you can either manually click backtrack and then it'll say backtrack is saved. This is where my clip is. I'm just going to delete it so that I can show you all that it is working. It is now empty so that the next time we do backtrack, it will be. So after setting everything up in 8M Vertical, you now have to connect to Mixitup in 8M so that they are talking to one another. Our goal here is to set up a hotkey command in Mixitup so that it connects to either your channel point or your exclamation point clip command. And then when you have that set up, it will then clip on Twitch, post on Discord, and also do the backtrack clipping for 8M. All right, now we are in Mixitup. So if you want to, there are a few ways to go about this. You can have it do a chat command, exclamation point clip. You can connect it to a channel point, or you can have both. If you are planning on doing both, I highly suggest making it in an action group. With an action group, you're able to create a command and then use that action group and put it into a channel point command, put it into a chat command. So instead of creating a separate chat command with all the sequences, channel point command with all the sequences, you just add the action group that you already created. Action groups are super duper useful. You do the work once and then it can be used in multiple applications. So let's just start with a new action group at the bottom here. Name this whatever you want. I'm just going to name this 8M clip so that for me, I know what it is. Command group over here, this is all of your folders basically. I'm going to put this into YouTube tutorial folder. You don't need to click this on unlock random, or you don't need to run one randomly. Under actions, we want to create a hotkey for this. So that will be the input keyboard and mouse. Add that in, type keyboard, keyboard key. So over on the 8M side, remember how I had number 8 alt control? I'm going to scroll down and find numpad 8, and the action is a click and then click control and alt. So now whenever this action group is run, the keyboard is automatically going to do a hotkey of 8 control alt, which is what we set it as for the 8M backtrack. Our second action is going to actually do a Twitch clip. You do action down here, do Twitch, add that. And then the type, we want to do a clip. You can test this out on your end to see if that works for you or not. Show the information in chat, and then result is clip URL. I am going to have my custom message say, thanks for clipping, it helps me make outside content. And then the result is going to be $ clip URL. This is the special identifier of the clip that you just took so that people who missed it can click on that link. And that should be it. Again, if you're interested on how to make this go into your Discord, I do have a separate tutorial. You can just mesh that all together. Let's just save. Now that we've created an action group, we actually now need to create a chat command as well as a channel point command with it. So let's first do the chat command. We go into commands. Let's do a new command. This is going to be 8M clip. And then mine, you don't need to include exclamation mark. Mine is going to be a clip because I already have a clip command. My command group is going to be YouTube tutorial. And then now under action, you can just do command and then run the command. The command type is going to be the action group. And over here, you then find the action group that you created. I did 8M clip, and then that's it. You just save. And now you've created a new command. To test this out, you can click on your chat room here and you can do exclamation point a clip or clip, whatever you have. Have that go. Oh, it says clip creation failed. Try again. Oh, it's because I'm not live. I was like, Why are you embarrassing me right now? What do you mean there's no clip? It's because I'm not live. Anyways, the actual action is still running. And then if you were to go to the folder of where you saved the clip, it should be right here. But that tells me that that is working. One note about the chat command, you can, of course, limit it to people. So you can limit it to regulars, to moderators, to only yourself, depending on whatever you want the case to be. Now let's also make a channel point with that. So let's go to Twitch channel points. You can either create a new channel point reward or add existing, depending if you already have it. I believe I already have something called a clip from last time, so I'm just going to add it to existing. The command group will be YouTube tutorial for me. And then again, same thing, we are going to add a command in here. We are adding the action group that we've already created on our first step, and then just press save. Over here, you then decide how much you want it to cost, and it should run as well. I'm going back to my scene over here. Let's find it. Here it is, a clip. Let's run it. Oh, I can't redeem it because I'm not live. Let's actually test it out over here. Let's just run it like this. So as you can see, it's created over here, and in my folder, there should now be two clips. And there you go. Those are the two clips. Now that you have this set up, whenever someone does clip in chat or uses a channel point, it should also record on the back end so that you have a TikTok or short form vertical video ready to go. If you're having issues with the hotkey, one thing that might be wrong is that your actual OBS setting is not set correctly. Go to settings, go to advanced, all the way at the bottom there is hotkeys. Never display hotkeys is what you should be clicking. If you do display hotkeys, or if you do the other settings, it means that if you're not actively clicking on the OBS window, the hotkey itself will not run. And there you have it. That is how you can use the Atom Vertical in line with Mix It Up. In the links down below, I will do a link to the Atom website, to the Mix It Up website, the Atom Discord in case you have something troubleshooting things to do, the Mix It Up Discord if you also need help there. And yeah, hopefully you found this helpful. If you want to learn a little bit more about Mix It Up, I do have tutorials on my profile. I also have short form tutorials if those are more your thing. Thanks for hanging out with me.